Hello and welcome to Cultist Simulator. My name is Whisperfire and it took 2 episodes. But if you recall, I screwed up majorly on a summoning ritual and ended up getting 2 corpses, which got picked up and was turned into damning evidence. And we spent the next 2 episodes after that trying to get rid of the evidence. Finally, the evidence downgraded to tentative, and then now it finally disappeared. So now the only thing that the hunter has is Mystique. So he should come up empty-handed. Thankfully, we can now go back to our expeditions. For now, we have been trying to keep a low profile. So let's dive right back into the expedition with locations inside the capital. The Strathcone residence. The house of Mr. Strathcone, a collector of rare objects. Strathcone will not sell his treasures, but a significantly cunning accomplice might gain entry. So, alright, let's do lantern. Alright, Cat. If you recall, Cat got a wound, a brutal experience from some monks at the congregation of St. Felix. Hopefully, she will be back and up for doing an expedition. So, we're going to get Lantern to kind of find a door, and a knock believer who can try to open the door. And we're going to give it some funds. Mr. Strathcone has a forbidden entry to his library. Unfortunate. Let's see what we can do. Expeditions need at least 1 funds per obstacle. Followers will defeat obstacles. If you run out of funds or followers, the expedition ends. Okay. And while we're at it, let's get some commissions. Okay, let's see what we got. I've given my agents the opportunity to serve. Let us hope it ends well for us all. And who do we got? We got this icon here. Watchers, mortals, perhaps even ordinary mortals, but quite a number of them. They could be fought, seduced, or deceived. Let's do deceive. Okay. And we will collect our commission. We got very substantial secret histories. That's why we're hanging on to at least one and not exploring with them all. While we're at it, we should try to get more secret histories through the Mansus. And to refresh about the sag door's riddle, what must open before this way opens? I have a strong feeling that it's knock lore, and you need lore of 6 in order to answer the riddle. We only have knock of 4. So that's not enough. We need to increase our knock lore. Everything else, we have lore 6 or higher. So, yeah. We got quite a bit of a collection of Spintria going. Yeah. Okay. Alright. We'll go ahead and take care of that. Let's handle our commissions. Let's see. Forge. And that is Reason. Okay. Do a little work on the side. They went that way. Let's give it another moth. Yeah. Okay. Alright, it looks like... Ooh. Yes! Good. Okay. Alright, I'm still concerned about this. I am safe for now. My adversary has not enough evidence to bring a case against me, and they have found no new clues. Thank goodness. This has held me back for 2 episodes. 2 whole freaking episodes of doing that. Okay. And we're gonna need some reason. Alright, we got some restlessness, but I'm not worried about it. Okay, let's see what we got. The bewilderment is our opportunity. We'll pass in silent secrecy. I'm gonna do another. And treasures lie before us, so this should hopefully be enough. Strathcone's cozy sanctum. A fire smolders in the gate. Glass cases display hard-won trinkets. We must seize what we can quickly. Strathcone may already have telephoned the police. We're getting 5 cards out of this. Okay. We got this. And we got some restlessness and dread. So this is just to do a sanity check. Yeah. Okay. Out into the night. We escape unseen, but the next day there are reports of a fire at Strathcone's. Did someone knock a live coal into the hearth rug, or did Strathcone destroy the place himself as part of some larger scheme? So, we got a journal. Traveling at Night, Volume 3. Another book. Another book. Okay. Alright, let's look at the loot. The Locksmith's Dreams, Stolen Reflections, the 4th volume of Teresa Gallner's expansive work. No longer a discussion of the dreams of artisans, but a valuable survey of other works. The tone is calmer than that of Transpasses, but occasionally fearful, even paranoid. This volume was published in 1926, but almost immediately recalled and pulped by the publisher, at the request of the author or possibly the authorities, depending on which story you believe. Few copies survive. And the Wancott Histories, subtitled Stories from Behind the Walls, a missionary of non-traditional stories compiled by William Gore, including battles not generally acknowledged and countries which appear on no map, told in a playful and apparently fictional manner. The Tristes of Underplaces. Herein, the 17th century mystic and antiquarian Claude Hersault describes the bounds or underplaces on the borders of dream. He warns that they shift over time. And Traveling at Night, Volume 3, the annotated dream journals of Christopher Illopoly, sometimes called the only readable occultist, literate, entertaining, bewildering. This is the 3rd volume, and it looks like we do not need to translate those. But what about this? The Journal of Alessandro Lacroix. Prince Alessandro Lacroix spent years in secret study of the tablets taken from the Fuchsine Martians in central Italy. His work will allow you to decipher Fuchsine text. Yes, we need Fuchsine. Develop an understanding of a long dead Fuchsine language. It has something in common with Latin and something else common with the scratchings of maddened rats. Okay, We got some notoriety. And it looks like we cannot revisit or reclaim that residence. Well, because it's a residence. Durr. Okay. Let's take care of the dread. We're going to go ahead and... Actually, can we use reminders? No. We're going to have to... Yeah. Okay, let's go on our next expedition, which is Cater and Hero Limited. It's been abandoned since the explosion when both the owners died. The machine stands silent. The building is a collapsing shell. Mr. Cater was known to display peculiar trinkets in his office. Perhaps some yet remain. Okay. So, Kat and Neville, you're my entry team. The remaining factory walls could topple at any moment. Blackened timbers creak in pain. We must equip ourselves properly and move with dreadful care. Expeditions need at least one funds per obstacle. Followers will defeat obstacles. If you run out of funds or followers, the expedition ends. Alright, let's see what we can do. I think we're good. Yep, we are doing good. What am I doing? Oh yeah, I was painting to get rid of the restlessness. I had completely forgot about that. Okay. We got contentment. So, dread. Contentment. We may have some tentative evidence. That's fine. I can live with that. Let's grab some mystique. Okay. We got our reason. Alright, let's see what else. Our expedition plans for the next challenge. It'll consume funds. I could add funds now, or I could send another follower. Treacherous ground. Pits and quags and sudden trembles. The earth here cannot be trusted. We need strong hands or clear sight. Forge or lantern. We already got lantern, so let's send Slee. Okay. The watchman shows mercy. Neither to our obstacles nor to us. If we're lucky, we may make it through. We're going to need Pope. Another lantern. Here we go. The watchmen will lend virtue to our lamps, that they will show us the perils to avoid. Probably. This should be enough. Alright. Okay. Develop an understanding of the long-dead Fusine language. In places, it overlaps with languages I know. In other places, well, I can see why they call it the tongue of witches. But I can understand it well enough now. Alright, we got ourselves another translator. A people lived east of the lost lake of Fushino. Horse warned that theirs was the land of witches. This was their language, called by some the dry tongue, and by others the tongue of witches. Alright. Let's do this one. This one had that really long lore about Teresa Galmir. I'm actually fascinated about this woman who apparently is at the Lodge of the Sage Knight. Janus is the gatekeeper of the twin god, the god that wounds, the messenger of changes, the sun, the moon. So we identify him with the watchman, the twins with the mother, with the forge, with the miniscate and the margard. He cannot be all of these, can he? The flamies knew the church, knew the dry land, knew the Elibus. Is he then synthesis, or is he something else? In Galicia, they called him Lamis Limis, but the obliterates are notorious for their slanders. That is a lot of stuff that just went over my head. I'm stumped. Okay, back to the expedition. A promising route reveals itself as a sucking snare. We'll have to go round and try again. The earth is hungry. Alright, what does this have? We got tentative evidence. Fine, whatever. Okay, fleeting remnants. Let's go back. Our expedition continues. Our expedition plans for the next challenge. It'll consume funds. I can add funds now, or I can send another follower. How about some knock? Enid? Yeah, okay, you should be able to do that. Okay. Oh, snap! An expedition member has fallen. It's Cat! Their runes are grievous. Cat, oh no. Oh. We gotta heal you. Quick. Poor Cat. Okay. Now, let's read the volume of the Locksmith's Dream. Janice has, they say, not one face, but two. To which I reply, why only one? Why only two? Hirschelt and Crossley, according to Thomas Love Denon, once agreed that Janice was all the gods and none. But later, Hirschelt insisted he was all the gods, and Crossley favored simply none. Denman was a sinister dilettante, but this rings true of them both. Merciful Mantra and the Iridas Parable. Alright, I do know that Janus is like a two-faced Roman god. Yeah, I don't know what they represent. But, yeah, Janus has two faces. Alright, next book. Gore does not mention the menace directly, but constant coy metaphysical references, ascending the staircase of years, to the doors of sleep, and to the blue light of dawn, suggest that he had commerce with the unseen world. Okay, so this is by William Gore. All right. Oh my goodness, worried about Cat. Okay. We call upon the watchman who is not compassionate. The watchman shows mercy, neither to our obstacles nor to us. If we're lucky, we may make it through. We lost Cat. Alright, not enough time. We don't have any of that. How about Edge? It probably won't do anything, I don't know. Sure. And Furtive Truth. Let's go back. Okay. Ooh-wee. A promising route reveals itself as a sucking snare. We'll have to go around and try again. Did we lose somebody? Please tell me we didn't lose anybody. Cat? Okay. The wound is healed, but this one came very close to death. Silence has touched him, like snow. She now has winter aspect, and another type, an old wound. Step closer to the sunset and see the first stars of night. So we got two wounds, but of different types. Okay, so she's gonna be okay. I hate to send her back into the fray, but we need a lantern. Okay. It was common in that time to speak of the division of the sun, by which contemporaries understood an eruption of barbarian forces and their uncouth gods. Bleh. Okay. Study Hersault's treatise of on underplaces. The walls of the Mansus, Hersault begins, are the size of starlight. Many of its directions are equally unhelpful, but common relationships do emerge. Alright. Okay. Supplies are low unless I send more funds. Okay, we'll send more funds. Our expedition plans for the next challenge. It will consume funds. I could add funds now, or I could send another follower. Okay. Okay. Woo! And I guess this will be helpful. Last night, I dreamt of a blue silk pavilion overlooking the cloudy labyrinth of the bounds. I listened to the mistress of the place speak of other visitors. The Suppression Bureau come here, did you know that? I think they hope to recruit me as an ally, she snorts assertively. After what they tried to do to Christopher? But their folly is your fortune. I will tell you something that may help you, if the Bureau ever troubles you. I wonder if this Teresa had a thing with this Christopher. Christopher as the author who explored the Mansus, Christopher Illopoly. And Teresa who wrote on the Locksmith Diaries and is now at the Sage Knight. The tent of the Sage Knight. The lodge, I mean. Okay, the watchman shows mercy neither to our obstacles nor to us. If we're lucky, we may make it through. Cat, I am so sorry, but you must come. We need the lamps. The watchman will lend virtue to our lamps, that they will show us the perils to avoid, probably. Okay. Please. We're mud splattered and thorn scratched, but we've made it through. Whew, that was hard. Alright, the picaresque account of a journey through nightmare, interspread with what might be partial rites. On the 18th ascent is the bud. On the 36th ascent, the blossom. Oh. Okay. An Indoctrinate rite. Wait a minute. I thought we already had one. Oh. Okay. Maybe we can get this to knock of six. Okay. Let's see what we need. Study the lore which opens. There are incantations of unseeming, where the space between the worlds is as potent as the actual syllables. When a thing is opened, we will know its nature. Alright, we'll see what we need to do that. Okay. Whew. Okay. Let's try funds. No. Let's try a little bit of... I guess. Okay. Okay. Hopefully this will do it. Cater's office. Here is the capacious room where Mr. Cater once watched his workers on the factory floor. The window glass is long gone. The rats and crows have made this place their battleground, but perhaps there is still something of use here. And it looks like we're going to get 5 cards. Okay. And what do we need here? Erudition. Okay. Let's grab this. Alright, let's read the conclusion of our expedition. 2 floorboards lift the way to reveal a hollow beneath Cater's desk. The rats had made free with the biscuits he stored there against the peckishness which haunts the entrepreneur, but they could not penetrate this iron lock box. A moment with a crowbar will open it. Let's see what we got. Bronze, an abandoned warehouse, an idol, a book, and vital pigment. Okay. So, let's go ahead and put that there. So, this is Grail. We could actually make a Grail masterpiece. This idol. The Marvain idol would make little wooden idols to placate the witch twins they feared in their lake. The lake is almost dry now, but the idols in the witch twins yet remain, yet shadowed with the aspect of the heart. So that's a heart relic, that's a grail relic. But this is a, okay. So we'll put that there. This is in Latin, okay. We can take care of that. Oh yeah, we're still studying that. Okay. We do have some notoriety. Where did it go? I don't see it. Hopefully, we could keep our favor from authority. Solucina? Need you to hang on to this for a minute. Okay. Gonna need erudition. See what this is. Tentative evidence. We have 2 tentative evidence. What the heck? The heck, dude? At least it's not damning. Jeez. Okay. I think we are done with expeditions for today. We got 2 locations nailed down. And we got 2 sets of tentative evidence, which is kind of curious. But we got a new project to study the Nock lore to get this to Nock of 6 so that we could try and answer the Stag Door's riddle. So, I'm going to go ahead and actually call this an early episode. And, yeah... Yeah, we're going to wait until the evidence cools down before we try another expedition, but we do have some study projects, which is great. So, I'm going to wrap it up here, so be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah!